the first thing we do is we indicate, we draw a horizontal line this way, then we'll pick a point of our choice, picking this point as my choice over here, then I'll call it point A. Now from our diagram, find out that there's a vertical line here over here to this other line here is 90 millimeter. So all what I need to do, I'll pick, I'll measure 90 millimeter from our point A to the right, but then I'll put a point, I'll call that point over there, call it point B. So I'll project point A upward. Project point A upward with the center line. Also project point B upward with the center line. This way. Now from point A, we'll have that our inner radius here is 20 diameter, so we'll divide by 2, which will give me 10 as radius. Place it at point A, then I'll draw a cycle. Draw a cycle. Now also you find out that the bigger cycle here at point A here is 40 millimeter diameter, so measure 20 as radius, place it at point A, then we'll draw a cycle. Over there. The next thing we'll do is that I said from this point here, from point B upward to a vertical line here is 32 millimeter. So pick 32 millimeter with our rule, measure 32 millimeter upward, then put the point. Now that same point here, we'll call that point point C. Now then we'll indicate point C with the center line. Over here, over there. So now at point C, we still have a diameter here of 40 millimeters. So our radius will be 20 millimeter. So pick 20 millimeters radius, place it at point C, and then we'll draw a cycle. Now, also from point C, they still have a diameter here of 70 millimeter. So divided by 2, it becomes 35 as radius. 1 to 35 millimeter as radius. I will place it back to point C and then I will draw a cycle. That way. Now you can recall when cycle touches each other externally, we add. So now this cycle here touches this cycle externally, the bigger cycle externally, with a radius of 20 millimeter over here. So we said this is their diameter already. So when you divide it by 2, you have the radius to this point. So the radius touching this arc here and this, now this is 20 millimeter touching 32 millimeter, so say 20 millimeter plus 32, which gives us 52 millimeter. So pick 52 millimeter with our rule, place it at point A, scribe an arc. Now similarly, this arc is touching this externally, so say 35, the radius here, bigger circle, the radius is 35. So say 35 is 70 divided by 2, give us the radius, which is 35 plus 32, which is touching this, plus 32, that will give us 67 millimeter. So pick 67 millimeter and I'll place it at point C, then we'll scribe the arc. Now at the point of the intersection, we'll open our radius to 32 millimeter. Now we've done that. So using the point of the intersection over here, scribe an arc touching the circumference of those circle, and then we'll stop. Now also we know that when circle touches each other internally, we subtract. So say 110 millimeter radius, 110 millimeter radius minus the radius of this, that is 35 millimeter, that'll give us 75 millimeter radius. So open our compass, measure 75 millimeters radius, then we'll place it at point C, then scribe an arc this way. Now also this is the radius here is 20 millimeter radius, so say 110 minus 20, 110 minus 20, that'll give us 90 millimeter as radius. So take our meter rule, take 90 millimeter, place it at point A, then we'll bisect the arc. Now at the point of the intersection, open our radius, open our compass, we'll measure 110 millimeter with our meter rule. Now using the point of the intersection, open to 110, which we've done, then we'll scribe our arc. Okay. Now we've succeeded in drawing a lever using the principle of tangency. Thank you for watching. Do have a blessed day ahead. Thank you. Also remember to give me a thumbs up and then subscribe to my channel. Thank you and God bless you.